throw on second down. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. Here's Jacobs on first and 10. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package, and that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
On second and 11 now, Carr. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
They're putting together a drive here in the final minutes of the half, but the coverage has been tight all game long, and they certainly want to keep them off the scoreboard here.
A long way to go here on third down for the eighth play of the drive. Throw. Oh, trying to get that to Adams, but that's intercepted. And the 49ers are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line.
Well, they were in a great position to take the lead, Charles. Obviously, all they needed was a field goal to do that. They wanted the touchdown. Unfortunately, they're going to get neither.
And you know every offense talks about the same thing each week, don't they, Brandon? They want to end every drive with a kick, whether it's a field goal attempt, a point after the touchdown, or at worst, a punt. This time they had that opportunity but didn't get it, because you know the field shrinks that close to the end zone, and that allows the defense to tighten up their coverage, and they pick that one off.
One of the great coaches said football is really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
They'll send a receiver here in motion right. Lance getting this out wide to Ayuk. And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. Third down, here's McCaffrey. And he'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the first. It's a 7-yard gain and good enough to move the chains.
Third and one, partner. No need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up the first down.
Second and 10. Lance now to throw. And he's got McCaffrey open, complete. And they're going to get this down to about the 37. Now the Niners going to signal for their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. And the Raiders call on a nickel set here for third down. To the ground attack here. It's McCaffrey.
And a very determined run there as he'll take this all the way down to the 27. Good effort.
A gain of 10 and a 49er first down. A CD a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast in the open field, but man, his first step is so quick too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield, but also when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast, the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
On second down, here's Lance. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. Lance's pass complete to Christian. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down, two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And no chance to get away as they get him down at about the 17-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
I'm looking at this with my defensive eyeglasses on because you remember the old days when a tight end saw a linebacker covering him and thought he had a mismatch? But the way they can run nowadays, not necessarily so. They gave it a shot downfield. That one incomplete.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
Well, normally you see three tight ends in a formation. You have to think to yourself, this has got to be a run. And I know as a safety, when I saw that, I took an extra step or two towards the line of scrimmage. Instead, they threw the ball, and he found one of those tight ends for a very nice pickup.
Lance, that's caught. He finds Danny Gray. He's got room at the 30, and he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. The catch and run pays off to the tune of 35 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. And a short gain here down to the 22. It was Anthony Averett who got him down.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. The pickup goes for 13. It sets him up first and goal.
Teams have a tough time running the ball as this one has throughout this game. It's so easy to just say, forget it. Let's throw the football. But that's exactly why you stay with the running game. Eventually, you stick with it. You make some adjustments. You often find ways to run the ball better as the game goes on.
And he gets halfway home from the 10 to the 5 on a pickup of 5. Now whistles here. I think one of the big boys for the 49ers might have jumped. Things made a little more difficult after the false start as they try again on second and goal. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. They fake the handoff. Now Lance. That is caught by the tight end Kittle. Touchdown, 49ers. A great effort there. A beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game. And the Niners have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive in the second half. Gold able to tack on the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point. But it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
Carr going to give it to Jacobs.
And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
53 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries. Those are the types of runs they told us they want to see more of. Look, they'd love the 60 to 70 yard runs, but those 10 to 20 yarders, they can help you win a ball game.
And that means everyone's invested, because you know the big guys up front, that's what they do. They try and move people. But when you get your perimeter guys involved downfield, that means that they care about the running game and they know it helps their team.
Another strong gain on the last two plays. They moved it a combined 33 yards. So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Once again, it's Jacobs. He'll get this down to the 38.
Josh Jacobs, the ball carrier. Tackle made at the 38-yard line. It's a pickup of 3.
Final minute now, the third quarter. From the 38, Carr. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And they are able to stop it, but he does take it all the way to the 2. 36 yards on the play.
That's a real nice job right there, working the middle of the field, working against those safeties. And you know, partner, if you get your hips turned the wrong way, big plays can result.
And a big play resulted right there. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Josh Jacobs taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Raiders are an extra point away from tying this ball game here in the final moments of the third quarter. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And we are tied at 14. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. Taken from about the 12 and taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. We've got a brand new ball game, all even after that last touchdown, so every drive now becoming a little more critical here in the second half. And this one will go to the 28-yard line.
Complete to Christian McCaffrey. A 7-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 3 at the 28-yard line.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off on it. Back now in Las Vegas. Welcome back, everybody. All square, 14 apiece to score as we get ready for the fourth quarter.
On the double.
On 2nd down, McCaffrey. And only able to get 2 here. Stopped at the 30. The Niners on 3rd down. A perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. They're looking at 3rd and a few inches. Now a give, right side McCaffrey. And some room to work. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 1st down, San Francisco. The pickup, 14 yards. The running game fully in sync, 1-11 on that play.
And sometimes it comes from the offensive coordinator, understanding what he thinks the defense is going to do and dialing up the perfect play. Sometimes the quarterback, though, can look at the defense, realize he needs to change it to a run, and that gets it done in a big way as well.
Give him 3 on 1st down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. Well, let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. 3 3-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on 4th down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
And now they'll throw with Lance. And this pass caught by Gray. And he's going to have another 1st down as the tackle comes at the Raiders' 38-yard line. Slot man moves right. On 1st down, this is McCaffrey. And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's been
becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. And they'll send the slot in motion left. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. That one, a first down pickup of eight.
But they're getting ready to go to work now. Prime real estate after that last run. Found his spot and picked up nice yardage, didn't he?
And now he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports.
Got it? Tight. 90 seconds.
First down, here's Mitchell. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
What a luxury to have a guy like this who can not only spell your starter, but can come in and keep drives going.
Second and seven from the 20. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Here we go, set. Run, stand.
Lance back to throw. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. And the 49ers are going to have a first and goal as he'll be taken down at the 7-yard line. He has been terrific today, hasn't he?
Yeah, absolutely. Running flawless 2-minute drill right here. This has been quarterbacking 101 with a flourish.
They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And he stopped immediately there. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go in the game. Lance looking to throw. The quick slant caught. And that's a touchdown as they've broken our tie here in the final minute of the fourth. Now gold for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14.
Makes the score Niners 21, Raiders 14. Robbie Gould to kick off for San Francisco.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. So remember, Charles, last time they were out here, they scored, but they just saw the opposition score, and they're trailing right now, so they're trying to keep pace here. They need a touchdown drive.
Well, if you're a fan of offense, you're loving this, but if you're a fan of defense, this is tough to watch, and it's also tough to keep that up when you just watch your opponent march down the field on a scoring drive. They lost in the double-digit snaps. You need to score here, not just to find the momentum from the last drive, but put the onus back on your opponent. And that's what they're doing right now, swapping that onus back and forth.
Now Carr. He hits Adams, complete. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Another big play as they get 28 out of that one. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Carr to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two.
brings up second and two at the 9-yard line.
What now? 2 yards left on second down from the 9. Here's Carr. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. And now time for one final play that has to be obviously in the end zone.
Can't wait to see what they call, but you want to get it to your best player. Sometimes you have to do it by formation. Move everyone to one side, and maybe he gets a one-on-one isolated on the backside.
Carr. And this nearly intercepted. Probably should have been. Had he caught it, it would have sealed it. Instead, one more chance coming up on fourth down.
What a great sequence by this defense so far. They've given him nowhere to go with the football.
And they just have to make it stand up one more time, because it appears that they've got their number. Can they not have a slip up here and allow the touchdown?
One final try now for Carr. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over. So the victory here for San Francisco. And they were spurred on by a strong performance in that fourth quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game. But when you throw one in the fourth quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger. And dominance is starting to take over, right? The way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through. And they closed them out with a big-time performance.
Dale, dale. Hey, hey. DJ Mosky, let's get it. Let's get it. We the champions here in Los Angeles. We doing numbers. Bringing home victory straight out the huddle. I met the plug, introduced to my brother. My squad superior, ain't none above us. We doing numbers. Gang in the building, we taking it over. Call the promoters. I just put up in this thing with my soldiers. I blew it and I'm still. Last minute, I'ma need me some. Call up Khalifa. Bring the in the. You know I stay with some bad lip, baby. TGOD, baby, no, that's a gang gang. Crazy girls after the game. We doing honest, we going the same. Pointers. Yeah, homies got me pointers. We get awards where we get God the glory. I'm shooting my shot most times I be scoring. Do this for my city, I bring on the truck. Feel like Freddie Mercury, we are. We the champions here in Los Angeles. We doing numbers. Bringing home victory straight out the huddle. I'm at the plug, introduced to my brother. My squad superior, ain't none above us. We doing numbers. Gang in the building, we taking it over.
Feeling like I can't miss. Maybe it's all in the wrist. You really wanna be the boss, it's expensive. Ain't the real champ if you never defend it. Put in that work, I'ma make them remember. I just broke down hella trees yelling timber. Stand in the line, they put me in the center. It blow they mind when they see how I'm winning. Went back and doubled up, now you in trouble. My on hustle, my diamonds are huddled up. TGOD got this off the muscle. Ask me about my life, man, I love it, I love it. Got so many rings, I need room for another one. Been through the pain, now it ain't no more struggle. My team win the game, put our face on the cover. Brother, we the champions.
Here in Los Angeles, we doing numbers. Bringing home victory straight out the huddle. I'm at the plug, introduced to my brother. My squad superior, ain't none above us. We doing numbers. Gang in the building, we taking it over.
Yeah, so that style not for you, but it's for me. Greenfield's finest. Boss.
Yeah.
DJ Drama.
Never let a wishbone grow where backbone should. Belly Ben Taylor, the dash on wood. Stand payments, the back ain't good. Got sense, but they act no good. Shot through the lot of the starstruck. Hop in the ride and we took in the truck, couple in the truck, and they all. They might say what's up when they see me around the city, but really no reason to talk much. Dinner and nice guy, but no nice guys here. I'm toe tagging, no Bill Bo baggins, y'all coming up short. Take a recess. This a heat check.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to legendary Lambeau Field in Green Bay. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the San Francisco 49ers and the Green Bay Packers. The veteran kicker, Robbie Gould, set to get us started. And off we go from Lambeau. Taken at the 15, a short kick. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. It'll go as a loss of a yard on the game's first play. Second down.
Well, sometimes it's hard to take your eyes off this guy at the linebacker position. He can really cover some ground, and he did there to make that play.
That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
As a coaching staff, you can call just about whatever you want because you understand you have guys who reliably take away those massive shots downfield. You're not as worried about giving up the big one.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
Rodgers to throw for it on fourth. Got a man, it's Tonyan. And he is going to have a Packers first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. 21 yards there, a big play on fourth down. Now a first down carry by Jones. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. On second and seven, Rodgers. He's got a man, complete. Touchdown, Packers.
And boy, CD, it's one thing to watch a great run, but when it's a great run with broken contact, it's like a cherry on top. That was a nice play.
On is Mason Crosby for the point after. And it's good to make it 7-0 Packers. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Taken from about the 12. And he returns this to the 22.
Lance and the 49ers now, first and 10.
At their own 22. They start on the ground with McCaffrey. They find some open field here. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first. Play action, now it's Lance. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. McCaffrey running up the middle. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back in the 46. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That's complete. It's Brandon Ayuk. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 30. McCaffrey on the counter. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Now Lance, able to find Gray here, and he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Eighth play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. To throw, it's Lance. That's over the middle and caught by Ayuk. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Up the gut, McCaffrey. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
First and goal and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back.
McCaffrey is in. Touchdown, 49ers. A strong, determined run there, Charles, to get in for 6 points.
This is why it's such a team game, isn't it? And I know it sounds really generic and it sounds almost trite, but the blocks were made up front, offensive line, collective victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield. And how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away.
Taken at the 15, a short kick. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent offer a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones to the 43, second down. Throwing on second and eight. Rodgers. Pass caught. It's Romeo Doubs. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 36. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run. So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 36. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Up the middle, Jones. Pretty nice aggressive run there before being brought down just inside of the 30. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Rodgers now to throw. Throw right side. This is into the hands of the tight end, Tonyan. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 18. Into the red zone. It's Rodgers. Caught left side by Cobb. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line. Working with a 2nd and 4. They go back to the ground with Jones. And he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. Rodgers going to try and throw on third down. And he's got his man. Touchdown, Green Bay. It's Alan Lazard. A great play there. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Packers will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. Crosby connects on the extra point. And that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Pulls it in at the 13. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And with him trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get into field goal range. Someone moved, flag is out. That's going to be 5 yards.
And that'll drive coaches crazy. You work all week on dealing with loud crowds, on dealing with motion, and then you have a guy jump.
A false start backs him up 5, 1st and 15. Here's Lance to throw it. He's going to air one out. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, 49ers. Danny Gray, 75 yards. And the Niners are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half. Gold with the extra point, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
A very limited time left to get into field goal range before the half, and they tried to get it all on one throw right there.
Throwing again on second and 10. Rodgers. And he fires one that's intercepted. He's certainly not been afraid to take some chances downfield. Now look, it's paid off for him a couple of times. That time, not so fortunate.
And that's where I want to start, what you said. It's paid off a couple of times. So his aggressiveness has been good for his offense for the most part. So he throws an interception there. No one likes that, but I would not rein him back in. The return on investment thus far has been pretty good. Two touchdowns to one interception.
Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On as the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And the 39-year-old veteran puts it right through. So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number 3 here. It's the 49ers out in front, and they will get the football first as well as we are back and started in the second half. Pulls it in at the 13. Good starting field position. He's out of bounds, but not before he's across the 35. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. This offense set to begin the third quarter, and Charles, if they had a checklist of things they wanted to accomplish in the first half, certainly at the top of that list would be having the lead, and they've got that here.
That's always the most important box to check, isn't it? But also, they've had some success in their passing game, so probably an empty box establishing the run. They're on pace for fewer than 100 yards in this one, so now they want to make sure that they get that going so they truly have a control in this ball game, and down the stretch, being able to be balanced, either throw it or run it, and try and win this ball game.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Throwing now is Lance. And the grab by Croft. And he's got Rome. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down.
Whenever we talk about moving the sticks and controlling the football, there's a great example right there. Those are the third downs you need to convert to win football games. We're in the third quarter of this one, and this is a tight one. In order to maintain pace, keep the ball away from the other team, and put points on the board, those are the plays they need to continue to convert.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Well, that's a good piece of quarterbacking right there, because he certainly felt the pressure coming. The alternative, getting sacked for the first time. He didn't like that option at all. Did a nice job saving yardage by throwing that one away.
Back to the air on second down. It's Lance. That's complete left side to Gray. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. Now they'll run the option to the short side left. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Trey Lance scampering home from 19 yards out. And the Niners take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Gold able to tack on the extra point. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And he nearly broke that for more, but as it is, still a good return. They'll start the drive right around the 37. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. They make their second half debut here, and things are looking a little bit tougher now. You give up the points there, Charles, that touchdown drive on the other side. So now it's a two-score game here. Got to be careful.
They certainly do, and I'm just wondering at halftime if those guys just looked into each other's eyes and realized what they've got to get done and come out a little bit more charged up, because if they don't get some kind of points here, the next drive, that can make this a three-possession game.
All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. He has it complete to Christian Watson. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Shotgun now for Rodgers. He's got the hookup with Dobbs. And they'll work this down inside the 30. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Now it's Rodgers. Completes it again to Dobbs. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Another first down as he went right back to the same well, this time for 17 yards. The red zone now. They'll look to throw. A quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
That was well played, but that was also an example of a corner who understands his coverage, realized he had support behind him, and could be a little more aggressive in the shorter zone, and did exactly that, knocking that pass away.
To throw once more on second and 10. Rodgers. Oh, it's tipped, but he still makes the adjustment. And the Packers are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game.
Over.
Jones will take this one in for a Packer touchdown. So how about that for an answer? They get the touchdown there, and it's back to a one-score game here in the fourth.
And that's what these guys have done all game long, because they've scratched and slashed their way to stay in this game. And by now, we should all realize they're not going away. Now the pressure again swings to their defense, because they're going to need to find some way to get the ball back.
after the touchdown. Here's Crosby to kick it away. Taken from about the 12. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10. Throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Lance now to throw. And this is incomplete.
This defense has passed its first two tests by forcing back-to-back incompletions. They know there's probably another throw coming up third down. Let's see if they decide to force the issue by sending people on a blitz.
Throwing his Lance on third down. Going for the deep ball. And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in.
The offense schemed, going five wide, trying to create a chance for the big shot, and they took it. If he comes down with that one, that's a huge offensive swing. But credit the defense with a nice play, knocking that one away.
Here we go. Yeah, go.
Lance and company going on fourth down. And that is caught. He's got his running back downfield. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive.
Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward.
They'll send a receiver in motion to the right. A handoff, McCaffrey running right. And he'll get what he can up the middle, 3 yards. That'll bring up second down. This a second and 7 from the 37. It'll be a gain of 5, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down. Here's Lance. Open man is Ayuk, complete. 11 yards for number 11.
But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered. But how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon.
Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. 6 yards left on second down. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. On play action, Lance. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. It's first and goal, and a late touchdown at this stage could officially salt this one away. This is McCaffrey on the give, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
Oh, Brandon, I'm going to tell you, this is football time to me. They're inside the 10-yard line. That's like drawing the line in the sand. Who's going to make the stand here? Defensive guys, they know if he gets in the end zone, this ball game is over. And the guys with the football right now, they're thinking, let's just pound it in there.
Got to hold him to three to keep this a one-score game. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 1:06 left to go in the game. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Here's Lance. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown.
Well, that was absolutely ideal for them, wasn't it? Trying to salt this game away. I think one of my kids just graduated in the amount of time they had the football. That was absolutely impressive.
Everybody wants those salt away the game drives. What makes them successful?
Well, when you're able to mix run pass, when you're able to control the football and stay ahead of the chains, I'm using every cliche I know, but that's how you get it done because you're not taking negative plays, and that way you're able to run what you want to run when you get a chance to call it.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. And a short kick taken at about the 16. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. To throw, Rodgers. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Well, this defense has been physical all game long, and it certainly looks like they're not going to back off and make things any easier. They want to keep making life miserable for the receivers all the way to the end.
Rodgers to throw. Watson making the catch. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5. To throw is Rodgers. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off by the former first rounder, Jimmy Ward. And the Niners are going to take possession of the football. But with the points that we've seen scored, neither defense has been at their best, but these guys have been a little bit better, Charles, and a nice interception there.
Yeah, you're right about that, Brandon. Let's face it. It's not always how you start, it's how you finish, right? So maybe you have a rough game all the way along, but if you make a big play like that at the right time, it can make everything turn out just okay.
And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Second down and 3. That one looks like he'll throw here. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. It's rare that a receiver of his caliber would drop one pass, but that's now 2 times he's had his mitts on one and lost it.
Yeah, I don't think that they're going to lose confidence in him, though, because of the track record. Such a good player, maybe having a bad game, but I think they'll still go to him in a critical spot.
He'll take a shot for the end zone. And this will be caught. Well, forget taking the knee. Some late gamesmanship here as they throw through. I just scraped it off the top. Went it on the road. Under curve, under block. Was already sold. I don't work by 10 o'clock. Too deep in the streets. Felt it, baby. The mental line. Whenever she comes, the word I gotta do. I'm moving. Tell me what I gotta do. Pull up in a bucket crew. One for me and one for you. Yeah, like with the roof. I'm off the chain, don't cut me loose. Yeah, I'm off the chain, I'm off the noose.